Kelly Olynyk has come in. So Olynyk, Kendrick Nunn, Andre Iguodala. Iguodala goes across the lane, lost it, got it back. Shot goes up, bounces around, and drops through. He gets his first, second field goal.
Well, these are big minutes for Nunn and Olynyk to try to work their back, their way back into the rotation for Eric Spoelstra and give him more speed in Nunn's case and more size in Olynyk's case. These are not just blowout minutes.
Again, Nunn was just had such a good rookie year. Feeds quickly, and Olynyk a quick bucket there. Olynyk, an excellent offensive player off the bench.
If you're the Lakers, I mean, Olynyk and Nunn are good enough to impact not just the game, but the series. You have to make sure I don't allow them to establish rhythm and get something going.
Rondo's in. The bench in the first half. Scored 20 points for the Lakers. Caldwell Pope misfires there, and the rebound goes to Nunn. Jimmy Butler with a three. So it's Howard, Davis, Danny Green, Caldwell Pope, and Rajon Rondo. Rondo pass inside to Green. Howard wants the ball. And he's fouled by Olynyk.
Well, Coach, you got to give a lot of credit to Dwight Howard, JaVale McGee. Not sure whether he was going to play or not. Every time they were called upon, they were ready. And especially in the case of Dwight Howard, don't at me, don't tweet me. The guy is a future Hall of Famer. He has the credentials that puts him there. He will be there. But give him credit for staying ready, staying prepared, and impact.
His career really revived in L.A. this year. This past summer of 2019, he was traded from Washington to Memphis. Memphis waived him. He'd gone pretty much because it was his 15 and 5 years when he signed with the Lakers. He'd gone from, as you say, a Hall of Fame career mark, franchise player, to a journeyman who wears out his welcome quickly. But he signed a non-guaranteed deal with the Lakers, embraced the role that he was asked to take. And it's amazing, of all teams to come back to, he had a 1 year with the Lakers and it didn't end well. He'd come back as an opponent and get booed every time at the Staples Center, but this year he played his role beautifully.
Well, Mark's right, without question. He's a three-time Defensive Player of the Year, NBA All-First Team. He had a serious back injury that limited his mobility, but where he got caught up was he wanted to be a primary focus offensively. He wanted the ball to go into the low post. When he came to LA, he accepted, we're going to play through LeBron James, Anthony Davis, and everybody else gets what they get. But the ball's not getting thrown into the low post. And I give him credit. He was almost out of the league. Now he's 4 wins away from a championship.
That one way off the mark for Dwight Howard. This is his second NBA Finals. The first one was in Orlando when he played for the Magic. And they lost to the LA Lakers. He'll sit down now. And he's played, started tonight. Hasn't scored, but has 8 rebounds, a couple of nice assists.
Well, he had beautiful passes to Anthony Davis, a couple with his left hand.